up? How you doing, fellas? You all right? What's up, man? Cool. What's up, man? All right, I'm safe, man. Come on in. Come on. What's up? Make some noise, fellas.
No doubt.
All right, fellas, I'm going to put you to work right off the top, all right? You ready to kick it out?
Yeah, we're going to lace y'all with a joint from the album Moment of Truth and on the Caught Up soundtrack called Work, because that's what we all about, putting in work, you know what I'm saying? Right. So let me set up when we get down.
Yeah, you heard a little taste of it, but we're going to give it to you live.
Big up to my man Cot B on the left right here.
Yo, give a round of applause for yourself, though.
Hard work, y'all. What you say, what you say?
What is it you want to do when you grow up?
Hey, yo, I'm going to be on Twitter. That's all my eyes can see. Victory is mine. Yeah, surprisingly, I've been laying, waiting for your next mistake. I put in work.
Escalate.
Connect the plots, networking like a conference. Cause the nonsense is yet to stop. Jake, shake me down.
Haters wanna take me down.
Break me down. Clap. All they heard was a sound.
Well, I scoped it out.
I took your weak dream and choked it out.
Your chick don't really got no ass. She just poked it out.
On the D-Lo, I'm saying you versus me, yo. We can do this stuff right here in front of your people. See, time is money, kid.
BS walks.
And to me, it's funny, kid, when you meet heads
talk.
I see feds talk. They wanna dig up the dirt.
So does it mean they hawk?
Cause I be.
Hey, yo,
we're gonna be a titter. That's all my eyes can see.
Victory is mine.
Yeah, surprisingly, I've been laying, waiting for your next mistake. I put in work.
Now watch my status escalate.
Your cornballs get stonewalled.
Blackball,
we own y'all.
The veteran,
running my plan. Yes, the better man. Crazy raw, doing my job like the mob.
Blazing y'all,
they're disappearing in a fog
or a mist.
And chicks can't resist when I kick. They be begging for attention or some more of the dip.
Hurt up, baby.
Somebody have to get hurt up, baby. Things be mad crazy, but I got to get the gravy. Platinum respect like the force of a tech. You be hitting the deck,
feeling heat in your chest.
Banging your thoughts with the hot onslaught.
I take a shot in the spot
for going where you should not.
Viciously,
I make history
instantly.
Those other fake ass loser ass suckers, they can play with me.
I'm
doing my thing now. The lamp
later on.
Paint the shade with some fly gators on.
Right now, grab me as they
get mud on my pants and shirt.
I get y'all niggas.
No, I be putting in work. Ooh,
that's how my eyes can see.
Victory is mine. Yeah, surprisingly, I've been laying, waiting for your next mistake.
I put in work and watch my status escalate.
I put in work.
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 Work.
Yeah.
Work.
Work. One time.
All right. Yes. All right, cool. Respect, man. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to bounce out Mass Appeal, and then we're going to come back and we're going to sit down and talk.
All right.
Grew with DJ Premier right here.
Gangsta.
Send you around featuring Gangsta.
A moment of truth.
Tonight we are featuring Gangstar, which features Guru. How you doing, man?
Yeah, what's up,
respect,
yo?
Respect, man. DJ Premier.
All right, no doubt.
All right, cool. And Cat, you're in the house still, aren't you? You still in the house? All the soulmates are definitely here.
Yeah.
All right, first I want to kind of hit you with is the fact that, you know, you guys have been together right, about 10 years now. How have you managed to, you know, to maintain such a strong relationship? Because as much as you're working partners, but you're also friends as well. So how have you managed to work?
See, when we started out in the rap game, we were mad broke. And, you know, like $2 a piece, you know what I'm saying? Like, can I get some of your fish sandwich, you know what I'm saying? You can lend me a couple of dollars, get some noodles. It was really like that. On the real, no jokes. And you know, we made it up together. So therefore, during that time, we had to learn how to differentiate between business and friendship. And the fact that we do that, and we do that well, is what kept us together. And plus, we got jerked together. So we had to learn to be businessmen as well as artists. You know what I'm saying? And elevate, because we had a lot of people depending on us. It's not just us, we represent a whole crew. You know what I'm saying? The chain and the star, Gangstar forever.
Now, how does it work in terms of your working relationship, in terms of like as artists and production? Because I mean, obviously you guys are, you know two of the baddest, obviously production as well as lyrically. How do you guys work in terms of your working relationship?
We contribute to each area. Like, I'll give him some titles maybe, and then he might like some of the titles, or he may give me titles to work from. Or like he does mostly all the tracks, but I might say, yo, on this one, could you try cutting this and this? And he might go, oh yeah, that's a dope idea. But it's a formula that we've been working on for years. We just, you know, evolve and elevate with the times, you know what I'm saying? Keeping everything pertinent, keeping everything relative to what's going on today, you know what I'm saying? So like in 94, we pushed the pause button after Hard to Earn. Now it's 98, we let the pause button off. Now you got Moment of Truth.
That was my next question. It's been 4 years. Why such a long delay? I mean, I know you guys are very busy and all.
Just to give our creator space, you know what I'm saying? He had Jazzmatazz number 2, which toured for quite a while. And during that break, a lot of people were asking for really what we already had, which is the Gangsta sound. So it seems like they wanted to get a little piece of that. So being I handle more of the production, I stepped in to do a little, you know, a little something on the side, you know, piece of Notorious B.I.G., rest in peace, you know, Jay-Z, Rakim, KRS-One, Nas, and many others. And,
yeah, man, a lot of others. And OC, and Rage.
Yeah, and that helps really to make Gangsta stronger, because what we give them whenever I do production on the side still is a reflection of what he and Guru and I do together as a group. And then, boom, when we get back together, our stuff's got to be just as strong or stronger to show that, you know, this is where it all stemmed from. And that's what it's all about when we do hip-hop, you know what I mean?
Now, March 31st is when the record drops here in Canada. What can we expect for all the people that have been waiting? It's definitely an anticipated record. What can we expect on this one?
20 new tracks, you know, it's the moment of truth. We're bringing it back to original beats and rhymes. It's a breath of fresh air to hip-hop, you know, to all of our lives, man, because we need this music to survive, whether it's to perform it or listen to it. You know what I'm saying? So we got special guests. We got M.O.P. from Brownsville, the firing squad. We got Scarface, you know what I'm saying? We got Inspector Deck from Wu-Tang and many others, you know what I'm saying? It's going on, definitely. We got a lot of new cats down with the Gangsta family, and it's on, you know? So y'all look out for that. It's definitely worth your dollars or, you know, whatever your currency is.
Canadian dollars, all that.
It's all good.
All right, now, in terms of, I mean, you guys are definitely, I mean, entrenched in hip-hop in terms of the fact that you obviously listen to and know what's going on business-wise and creatively. What have you guys been thinking about in terms of what has happened over the last few years with hip-hop and kind of share your thoughts on that?
It's like the pendulum is switching back now, like I said, to those groups that's based on that, you know, those essential elements that the art form started with. Turntables and a mic.
Word up.
And you know, even sampling for us is an art form. So instead of 2 turntables, it's like 32. You know, so we're just using that same intensity and that same hunger, and we're doing it for love and for fun too. You know what I'm saying? Not just for the loot. You know, you can't sacrifice your values, man, for some quick loot. Everybody today is looking for instant gratification. You know what I mean?
All right, well, we're going to come back a little later on. You're going to get to check out a live performance of You Know My Steez as well. We're going to get to check out your questions. We have questions in the house as well as we're going to open up the vibe line for questions for Gangsta. But right now, just to get a rep, Gangsta right here on To Mix.
But there, Grah.
Hey, yo, but I say we just get some money, man. I'm kind of broke.
All right, so we're definitely back here coming at you live because Gangstar's in the round and it's your chance to get your questions in. And we have an email question. And where is that? There it is. Okay. Now, can we... there we go. Thank you. I was wondering if y'all planning on any kind of Canadian Moments of Truth tour, especially out here in Western Canada, because I'd pay mad money to see Primo on the tables and Guru on the mic. Peace of love, DJ Roach in Red Deer, Alberta.
Much love to DJ Roach.
Word up. Yeah, we're going to do a tour. What we're doing right now, the album comes out March 31st, and once y'all pick that up and study it for a couple of months, then we'll see if y'all did y'all homework. So we're going to give a couple months time and get our show together so it's tight, play all the old joints we came up on that y'all remember us by, and play a lot of joints from the new album to blow that up, maybe bring a couple special guests with us, and then boom, it's going to be on. But we definitely going to do that. We were just talking to Russ from our label about doing the Western side. He was saying it's a real powerful side over there. So you will be seeing us in your area from Western to Toronto to everywhere else of Canada. Every place they love hip-hop, you're going to see us and feel us. Turntables and the mic, no debts.
Word.
All right, we have a phone call. Caller on the line?
Yeah.
Hi, who's this?
This is Skills.
All right, Skills.
What up, Skills?
What's up, what's up?
Where you calling from?
The ODOT, Ottawa.
All right, so, all right.
Yo, so, yo, I know the Biggie and the Tupac murders were like the worst and darkest moment in hip-hop. But I mean, what do you guys feel was has been the most inspirational and positive moment in hip-hop, you know? Something that you could say, yeah, I'm hip-hop, this is hip-hop, and it's here to stay, yo.
You said, what makes us say, yeah, this is hip-hop?
Yeah, like, there's gotta be something that happened, you know, that made you guys feel like that you're proud to be.
From the first day I seen breakdancing and all that, I knew I was a part of that. And the graffiti and everything. So it was like it identified with me without even having to ask what it was, because I knew without even knowing, you know what I mean? So that right there knew I belonged to that culture, and that's why we're still here now. I'm 30 years old, so that shows you it ain't too late to still keep rocking. You know what I mean? It's about where your heart's at. And my heart is in hip-hop, so I'm going to live forever off of this, for real.
Same. Cool. Well, right. I hope you see you when you're like 60.
Yeah, 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 just like KRS, till I'm mother.
Word is born.
All right, so we got a question, in-house question, so let's bounce over.
All right.
Here. All right, what's your name?
Nana.
All right, your question is?
First, I want to say big up my crew, Embassy crew up in KDOT, Waterloo. Second, I want to say the Primo. I just want to know what type of music that you listen to, because I'm hoping to produce one day.
Right.
I want to know what inspires you into getting what is out there, the gangster.
I listen to everything from hip-hop to jazz to slow jams.
To rock and roll.
Yeah, to rock. I like rock music. I like the punk thrash, hard metal, all that. I mean, a lot of music was in my family as far as records is concerned. None of my parents played no instruments or nothing like that. But just as far as it being around me, from Dionne Warwick to Nancy Wilson to, you know, Marvin Gaye to Al Green, to the stuff I was buying, like Cameo and Confunction and all that type of stuff.
Yeah,
all that. That's just part of the tools that I use, and I just keep elevating from there. But I convert it to hip-hop format, and all of us know how that go. So it's got to have that type of a sound.
He could take the sound from somebody's beeper or from the telephone ring or whatever to make your head bob, put it with a beat, make your neck
true,
break.
True, true, true.
All right, we got another question. We got another question over here. All right, what's your name?
Jay.
Your question is?
Okay, first of all, I just want to say that both of y'all are the illest and good best hip-hop group ever. For real.
Good looking, Jay.
Thank you,
no
man.
Doubt.
Thank you. My man.
That's a blessing.
And secondly, I want to know what your thoughts on the Cannabis LL situation are, the beef. And two-part question. And I heard a rumor that you're in the studio with LL doing a comeback, Primo. Oh. So.
Well, as far as... You answer the rumor thing first. You want to answer that first?
Yeah. Right. LL ain't called me yet. He's been to my crib before when we play him some beats, but not because of the Cannabis joint. That was back when he was working on Mr. Smith album, but we never got a chance to, you know, do anything. But in New York, everywhere I go, that's the same rumor that's being kicked around. Even I'm surprised. I ain't heard nothing yet, though. LL ain't called me, so. But if he asked me to do it, I would do it. And I am doing one with Cannabis, you know, on his album. So whether they do a battle or not, I'm still doing one for Cannabis. But either one of them asked me to do it, I would do it, because that's how battling began, to keep from beefing and all that. But out of the two, I like LL's joint, but Cannabis whipped a little butt, though.
Yeah, but I heard, check out, but I heard that LL is in with Dre. Not the song he has with Dre with the Zoom, Zoom, Zoom. Not that one. I heard he's doing the battle one with Dre. That's what I heard.
But never sleep on L, though.
And don't sleep on L, because he's original. Never sleep on no original cats. Right.
No doubt.
All right. Now it's about time to bounce out your video picks. Premier, what did you want to see? Video?
Yeah. I want to see Eric B. and Rakim. I Ain't No Joke.
All right. And what did you want to check out, Guru? Yeah,
that one. The Kills now.
Yeah. The new joint from my man Capadonna from Wu-Tang. Word, run for your life. Word.
All right, let's kick that out. We'll be back with more Mix and Drown featuring Gangsta.
Yeah, in the round.
All right, soulmates, Smash T's coming back here with Gangstar, because we are in the round. And there's one track that has been kicking out for the last few months, and I think we all know what the track is. Do we know what the track is? Gangstar.
Steve.
What is it?
You know my Steve.
What is it?
You know my Steve.
What is it?
You know my Steve.
Nice work, fellas. Gang Style, let's kick it out live right here on The Mix and Durant, Soulmates.
Yo, as always, we always come to you with
the real hip-hop MCing and DJing from your own mind, you know?
Y'all think it's time to start the show, Paul?
For real.
Who's your suspicious character strap? With your sounds profound, similar to the rounds spit by derringers.
You're in the terror zone,
like my man Chuck D says. Inside the deep throne, you close, and all you
knuckleheads.
Cause MCs have used up extended warranties, while real MCs and DJs are a minority. So right about now, I use my authority.
What?
Cause I'm like the wizard,
and you look lost like Dorothy.
Behind me when I return for my real people.
Words
you split with, hitting like some double
desert eagles.
Four caps full of
and baggy slacks.
Attacking all the rappers who rap over the mid tracks. So fear facts have brought the rap game to near collapse. So as I have in the past, I went back. Dropping lyrics that be harder than sex and candle wax. And one-dimensional MCs can handle that. While the world's revolving on its axis, I come with mad lover plus the illest warlike tactics. The wilderness is filled with this. So many people searching for false flips. I'm here with the skills you miss. The rejected stone is now the cornerstone. Sort of like the master builder when I make my way home. You know my
Yeah.
You know,
New York City,
real.
Toronto.
Let them know. Do your thing, y'all. Yeah. Y'all know what the deal is. To the beach, y'all.
Don't be the sinister. Primo makes you relax. I'm like the minister.
When I be lacing the wax,
I be bringing salvation through the way that I rap. And you know, and I know, I'm nice,
nice like that.
Work through worldly problems. I got the healing power when the mic's within my reach.
I'm feeling more power.
Stealing at least 3 minutes of every rap radio hour. It's often easier for one to give advice than it is for a person to run one's own life. That's why I can't be caught up in all the hype. I keep my soul tight and let these lines take flight. The apparatus gets blessed, suckers get put to rest. No more of being pure, I got the cure for this mess.
So what is
this? Wackness is spreading like the plague. MC's locked up and got paid, but still can make the freaking grade. How many times are one of these gonna lie? They must wanna die,
they can't touch
the knowledge I personify. I travel through the darkness, carrying my torch, the illest soldier. When I'm holding down the fort,
you know my steeds.
Let them know.
Yeah. Keep it live.
You know my steeds.
Keep it live.
Let them know. DJ, come on.
You know my steeds.
Let them know.
Do your thing, y'all.
Keep it live. You know my steeds.
Let them
know.
Do your thing, y'all.
What you bless? What you bless? What you bless? The mic.
On the microphone, you know that I'm one of the best yet. Some punks ain't paid all of their debts yet. Trying to be fly, riding high on the jet set. With juvenile rhymes, making fake-ass death threats. Big deal, like in Vogue, it's time to can feel. Styles more tangible, and image more real. For some time now, I've held the scrolls and manuscripts. When it's time to go all out, you'll be like, damn, I flip. Yo.
With the bull.
That's a lyrical bull clip. Giving you a verbal ass. Don't trip. It's the gifted, prolific one. Knowing it's
ball head slip.
Why is the pressure on my head? My style be wilder than a kamikaze pilot. Don't try it.
Don't try.
I'm about to stop more than a friggin' riot. Styles unsurpassable. And knockers and suckers.
Yo,
them little suckers are harassable. For I be speaking from my parables. Carry you beyond.
The mic's out of the magic wand.
A risk is tragic like the havoc of a nuclear bomb.
And I grab your palm.
No potion. You're gone. And if you thought we lose our niche in this rap stuff, you way wrong.
I stay up,
stay on. Shine bright like
neon.
You're so pathetic, synthetic like
rayon.
Fat beast, they play on.
My
dope rhymes for me on. Word is born.
Check this out,
you know my steeds.
Stay up, stay up. Let's sing it up.
No All right, doubt, no doubt.
Thanks, man. Kai B. Thanks, man. All right, DJ Premier. All right, man, thank you. All right, we're kind of winding down, and we got like about 20 seconds to let you know. March the 31st, the place to be is the album is Moment of Truth. You definitely got to pick up the Gangsta. Y'all going to pick it up or what?
Yeah.
Want to thank you all for coming out. Soulmates, make some noise for Gangsta. Make some noise for them.
Big up.
Also featured on the album is this video we're going to check out. We're out of here. Royalty right here. Feature Casey and JoJo.
Full effect.
It's yours. Thank you.